Joshua Biansi, an administrative assistant at MOOB's Disability Research and Learning Center, explains that people with disabilities, or PWDs, are still sidelined in relation to access to crucial information.
There is a challenge of communication. Students don't know how to communicate in sign language, so that one becomes a big communication gap.
You know, some of them will ignore some of things which you will try to explain to them to help you.
A number of laws and policies have equally been adopted pertaining to PWDs, including Article 21 of the Ugandan Constitution and the Persons with Disabilities Act of 2006, which both prohibit discrimination against PWDs and towards equal opportunities. Unluckily, though, to the visually impaired, the content contained in these laws is still distant to their understanding, except when told by another person.
One, they should enforce accessibility laws and regulations. Like any information which is coming, it must be braille. It should not come only printed. It must be braille. Like government, let me say the government jobs, the government programs also should come as printed. At the same time, they should come as braille.
I would like us to be included. I'm visually impaired, but right now we are not included. We are not so much included because, like, we need these packing machines, the braille papers to be included in medical sectors, like the clinical room. We need them to be placed there so that we can work with people with disabilities.
Persons with disabilities now want the government to step forward to translate all information to a leverage understanding.
Now we're requesting government to help us in other policies like Polish development model and others, so that we can access the information in those policies.
It can help by appointing interpreters, such that when the person is going to the hospital there, so for example, if they are talking about information about HIV, so the interpreter can help to interpret for the deaf, for to make them understand.
To look at us also as people who are very important, because we are citizens, we are Ugandans. So at least everything should be put in braille, like the constitution should also have a provision of braille whereby a person who is visually impaired can also access the constitution.
Determined to end stigma and discrimination by 2030, the Uganda AIDS Commission has summed up efforts and launched the translated version of the National Policy Guidelines on Ending HIV Stigma and Discrimination for Persons with Disabilities this week, specifically for the blind and deaf, through braille material and sign language respectively.
Our colleagues who have HIV and are living with HIV and AIDS, but also persons with disabilities. They are those who think that if they go to the health facilities, they will not get help. We call that internal stigma. But of course, it is also a fact that they are stigmatized by the community members, they are stigmatized by some health workers, and so to fight all that stigma and improve access to care, we have come up with these guidelines.
The State Minister for Disability Affairs, Helen Grace Asamo, says that for a long time there have been misconceptions attached to PWDs and HIV/AIDS, which has only helped to accelerate stigma and discrimination.
Despite the positive progress, we need to do more as we work towards AIDS as a public health threat by 2030, especially among vulnerable groups such as persons with disabilities.
The Uganda Bureau of Statistics in 2016 indicated that 12.4% of Ugandan population live with some form of disability, translating to approximately 4.5 million Ugandans. Failure to access information by PWDs equates to limited achievement of national development plans in one way or the other. Story compiled by Derek Asaba for the news.